temperature rises, and all around me are tiny white flies. What I'm seeing is a food chain coming to life. Mayflies hatch. And then the smaller fish start to feed, which brings out an apex predator. The tiger. And right on cue, Andy gets a hit.
Hi. I saw a white belly that looked like a tiger. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Cold water. Look at what it is. Pretty cold. They're that close, but too late for them. Just here.
Our first time in the north. Still no monster, but it gives me a chance to show Andy the kind of data we're looking for.
If you can record the length of the breath, feel your chicken head, the cardosis,
74 centimeters.
So you get a breath from all the
because I'd like to know if the fish here are genetically related to the kind of in our test area, or if they're distinct subspecies.
That's enough.
All that's left to do is safely let them go.
When you release fish, you want to release them in water with a little bit of current, and then if you actually twist their body, and they can right themselves, then that's an indication that this fish is ready to be released. If I twist his body and he just goes belly up, then obviously this fish will actually need a little bit more time to recover.
And as soon as I let this one slip away, Andy gets another hit. Another timer. This one's a fighter. Diving under logs to get rid of the hook.
Nice! That's a big fish. I don't know if you'll let me grab it. Oh, beautiful fish. Look at that. Whoa! Nice song. I think he's ready to go back to the Yay! Yeah, I mean, definitely ready to go back. Release!
That was a nice fish. Close to the size I'm looking for, but it escaped. And it has to be the last catch of the day. We're back at base camp, and the truck is waiting to take me on the side.